starters. First for the Highlanders. At forward, number 3, Amanda Morrison. At guard, number 5, Alexis Miller. At the other guard, number 11, Paige Johnson.
I'm getting a lot of
sense. At forward, number 24, Leia Westlock. And at center, number 34, Aaron Harkala. And now for the Vikings. At center, number 5, Carson Tripp.
I don't know what's going on.
At guard, number 12, Megan Moen. At the other guard, number 20, Andy Simmons. At forward, number 23, Shannon Poitel. And at guard, number 30, Sidney Bennett.
Well, I like.
The Highlanders coached by Tim Chesky. Vikings by Bob Currier. Officials for tonight's game, Troy Gladstone. Leon Holden, Scott Helman.
Thank you.
5, Alexis Miller. For second, team third. And for the Highlanders, number 10, Rhea Petzing. Thank you. As of number 12, Megan Muller, second. Team third. Check in for as of number 2, Ellie McCain.
Oh, question.
Has number 12, Megan Boyd, her third, team six. Kennedy from Howell, number three, and the horseman of the Vikings, number 20, Mason Williams.
Thank you.
14, Tina Woodward. Her first, team 8. At the line, shooting 1. Number 3, Amanda Forsman.
Thank you.
We're still alive.
What does it mean to be a true fan? Fan is the abbreviation for fanatic, which Webster's defines as one marked by excessive devotion to a cause or idea. Yeah, that sounds about right. For the last 4 years, the Michigan High School Athletic Association has scoured the Mitten for the best fans in the land. The mission of the Battle of the Fans contest is to find the top student cheering section in the state. Are you ready, kids? I can't hear you! Being loud, as you can imagine, is a prerequisite, but first and foremost, it's about promoting positive sportsmanship, student body participation, school spirit, originality of cheers, organization of the group, student leadership, and, oh yeah, fun.
We've really found that the culture is starting to change at schools in regards to sportsmanship around the state. We've got a number of schools that have been involved, and they tell us, their administrators tell us, just how their hallways have changed, their games have changed, and I think it's because it's become kind of a fun and cool thing to do on a Friday night.
Schools were encouraged to produce up to a 3-minute video highlighting their student section. From there, 5 finalists were selected, and a public vote was held on Facebook, Twitter, and the MHSAA Instagram pages. Say cheese! At that point, it was up to the Student Advisory Council and MHSAA representatives to determine where the next BOTF championship banner would reside. The student sections from Yale, St. John's, Dowagiac, and 2013 winner Buchanan and 2014 champion Beaverton made the finals. Each had one last chance to state their case.
Getting everybody together, getting loud, going crazy all night long, running the skits perfectly, and just doing what we do every day, and that's win.
Basketball team's first. Whether we win or lose this competition, it doesn't matter. We help the community and we help the basketball team, and those two goals are done. But a secondary objective, winning that would be cool too.
We're back and better than ever.
Yeah!
Loud. Fun. Enthusiastic. Togetherness. How do you pick just one? Well, you go with the most united.
I'm proud to be a chieftain.
Give me a D. Give me an O. Give me a, heck, we'll be here all night. Congratulations to the Attack of Dowagiac, home of the best fans in the state of Michigan for 2015.
As the voice of Michigan's student athletes, the Student Advisory Council's role
is to convey the message of how high school sports are supposed to be played. We are responsible for helping the MHSAA maintain a positive and healthy atmosphere
in which interscholastic athletes can thrive.
We believe athletes should be competitive,
sportsmanlike, and excel academically.
We believe students in the stands should have fun,
but not take the focus away from the game.
We believe coaches should act as teachers, helping student athletes develop
while still keeping high school sports in perspective.
We believe that parents should always be positive role models
and be supportive of their child's decisions.
We believe officials commit their own time to high school sports
and respect should always be shown and given to them.
The most important goal for student athletes is to enjoy high school sports
while keeping a high level of respect between all those involved in the games.
I officiate because it's a great way to stay connected to the sport I love.
I officiate because I love to be involved in the sport and it continues to keep me in shape. It gives me an opportunity to be part of the activities as they still go on.
Sports were a big part of my life
and I like the opportunity to give back, and I feel that I can make a difference and be a role model to a lot of young aspiring officials, and especially females, which we really need.
You can be a referee.
I knew before it even left my hand. Why? Because every shot I take is the most important one of my life.
As the voice of Michigan's student athletes, the Student Advisory Council's role
is to convey the message of how high school sports are supposed to be played. We are responsible for helping the MHSAA maintain a positive and healthy atmosphere
in which interscholastic athletes can thrive.
We believe athletes should be competitive,
sportsmanlike, and excel academically.
We believe students in the stands should have fun,
but not take the focus away from the game.
We believe coaches should act as teachers, helping student athletes develop
while still keeping high school sports in perspective.
We believe that parents should always be positive role models
and be supportive of their child's decisions.
We believe officials commit their own time to high school sports,
and respect should always be shown and given to them.
The most important goal for student athletes is to enjoy high school sports
while keeping a high level of respect between all those involved in the games.
What does it mean to be a true fan? Fan is the abbreviation for fanatic, which Webster's defines as one marked by excessive devotion to a cause or idea. Yeah, that sounds about right. For the last 4 years, the Michigan High School Athletic Association has scoured the mitten for the best fans in the land. The mission of the Battle of the Fans contest is to find the top student cheering section in the state. Are you ready, kids? I can't hear you! Being loud, as you can imagine, is a prerequisite, but first and foremost, it's about promoting positive sportsmanship, student body participation, school spirit, originality of cheers, organization of the group, student leadership, and, oh yeah, fun.
We've really found that the culture is starting to change at schools in regards to sportsmanship around the state. We've got a number of schools that have been involved, and they tell us, their administrators tell us, just how their hallways have changed, their games have changed, and I think it's because it's become kind of a fun and cool thing to do on a Friday night.
Schools were encouraged to produce up to a 3-minute video highlighting their student section. From there, 5 finalists were selected, and a public vote was held on Facebook, Twitter, and the MHSAA Instagram pages. Say cheese! At that point, it was up to the Student Advisory Council and MHSAA representatives to determine where the next BOTF championship banner would reside.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
The student sections from Yale, St. John's, Dowagiac, and 2013 winner Buchanan and 2014 champion Beaverton made the finals. Each had one last chance to state their case.
Getting everybody together.
Thank you.
Thank you. Janet Twitchell for three.
Thank you.
Carson Tripp.
Thank you.
the Vikings number 5, Carson Tripp.
Thank you.
set. Team 9 at the line for the Vikings.